In this screencast, I'm going to show you the solver tools in MATLAB. So depending upon what you want to solve, MATLAB's got a bunch of built-in solvers. If you want to solve for the roots of a polynomial equation, you can do that quite easily. The roots of a single nonlinear algebraic equation, systems of linear algebraic equations, systems of nonlinear algebraic equations, the maximum or minimum of a function. You can optimize a function of several variables, and you can integrate. So I'm going to go through each of these and go through an example. So if we have a polynomial, there's a built-in roots function. In MATLAB, I can put in a vector here into the roots function. So my coefficients, 5x cubed, 2x squared minus 4x plus 9, I put in a vector inside the roots function. And when I press go, it gives me the roots of that polynomial. And you see that two of these are imaginary roots. What about solving for the root of a nonlinear algebraic equation? An example is shown here, and we want to find a root of this equation near x equals 1. The first thing I'm going to do is set this up in the MATLAB editor. I've defined my equation here, and I can save this in a directory. I can close this down, and I'm ready to use it in the MATLAB command window. So I can type it in here, solution equals f0. We're going to use the f0 because it's a function of a single variable. Now I have a function handle of the function I just defined at f, and our initial guess is 1. And when I press go, it cranks it out, and it's 0.7836. Now what if we have a system of linear equations, as shown here? So we can do this easily in MATLAB. So we see that this is set up in the form AX equals B, where A is a coefficient matrix, and B is the resultant vector. So I've defined what A is, and B, the resultant vector. And in the command window, I can do this two ways. I can say x equals the inverse of A times B. Or in MATLAB, you can just use the backslash. So A backslash B, and you get the same thing. So these are the x1, x2, and x3 that satisfy that system of the three equations and three unknowns. Now we have a more complex problem where we have a system of nonlinear equations. So we have two equations and two unknowns, but they're nonlinear. The first thing I've done is defined a function, z equals equations x, and we do have two input variables. We have an x and a y, but what I'm basically doing is I have a vector of inputs, and x1 is equal to x, and x2 is equal to y. So just an example to show you that my function works. I'm going to do the equations of 3, 4, and again, we just have a single input into that function equations, but it's going to be a vector because we have x1 and x2. So we have two components of the x vector input, and that gives us an answer. So now we wish to solve that system of the two equations. The first thing I'm going to do is show you how to set this up. And so we have our solution that's going to be fsolve. We're using the fsolve function in MATLAB. And here we use a function handle at equations, so we're using our equations as our function that we're trying to solve. And then we have an initial guess here. So this would be x equals 0.6 and y equals 0.5. And again, we have a vector x that we're working with, so we have to put this into vector form. 0.6 and 0.5 is our initial estimate. When I press enter, we see solution to our two simultaneous equations. Now if we wish to suppress all this output that came out after we ran that command, I can type in options equals optim set, and then display in single quotations, and then off in single quotations, and I press enter. That will define this options, and then I'm going to re-input my equation, and I'm just going to add options at the end. If you do it in this way, you can guarantee that when you press enter, it's not going to spit out all this stuff. Next, MATLAB can determine the maximum or minimum of a function in one variable. So for example, let's say we wanted to find the minimum of this function in the interval 0 to 5. The first thing I've done is set up a function, y equals fm of x. So using the fminbound function in MATLAB, I can determine an x minimum. So fm is the function, and I put the at sign because it's a function handle. And then we're going between 0 and 5. So this will calculate the minimum of fm between 0 and 5, and when I press go, it tells me that the minimum occurs at 3.93. If I wanted to actually determine what that minimum was, I could just do fm of x min, and that tells me the minimum of the function between 0 and 5 is about negative 19. Next, we might be interested in finding the maximum or minimum of a function of two variables. So here we have a function of s and t, and we might want to find what the maximum y value in a certain interval. So s between 0 and 10 and t between 0 and 10. I've got a rough plot of this. What we see is there's a couple maximum here. The first thing I've done is I've set up this function in the editor, fopt, and again, we're going to put in a vector here, so x is actually going to be a vector, and you see that y, which is the output, depends upon x1, so the first component of that vector, and x2. So this is going to be our s and our t. So s corresponds to x1, t corresponds to x2. Another thing you'll notice is I put a negative here in front of the entire equation. There's no way to calculate the maximum of a function in MATLAB. What you have to do is calculate the minimum of the negative of that function. So we're putting negative here to make that the negative function, and then we're actually going to find the minimum of this function, which is the maximum of the initial function. So it's kind of like a double negative. Similar to the fsolve function, I'm going to declare some options here. I'm putting a couple different things in here. I'm saying display is off, algorithm and is active set. Next, the fmincon is the function we're going to use to find the minimum of a equation of two variables subject to constraints. So that's where the con comes in. If I take a closer look at this, I've got initial estimates for my s and t, and there's a bunch of stuff in here that is optional, and then towards the end we have the constraints on s and t. So when I run this, and then I type in xmax, so xmax is a output of our fmincon, xmax is going to be 4.49 and 6.20, so that corresponds to the s and t values that actually provide the maximum of our function, or the minimum of our negative function. And then mymax, which is actually the second output of the fmincon function, is negative 674, and keep in mind that that's the minimum of the function, and so the maximum of the original function is just going to be the negative of this. So the maximum is 674 at an s value of 4.49 and a t of 6.205. The last type of solving technique in MATLAB that I'm going to talk about is numerical integration. So that's estimating the area underneath a curve. So for example, here we have cosine x times the hyperbolic cosine of x minus 1. We want to find the area between 0 and 5. And keep in mind that we're going to have a negative area here because the function is negative for most of this domain. And we can use the quad L function in MATLAB. You can also use the quad function. They're pretty similar, it's just they use different algorithms. So I'm going to be using the same function, fm, that I set up originally. And when I type in area equals quad L, using my function handle for fm, between 0 and 5, it tells me that the area is about negative 30.